The Mama Take Heart podcast with Rabrina Rettle is brought to you by Life Audio and is a part of our Faith Toolkit series. For more inspirational, faith-affirming podcasts, visit lifeaudio.com.
Welcome back, listeners, to Mama Take Heart, Understanding Your Gen Z Girl. This is episode 3, and I'm Rabrina Rettle, and I'm here to help you be the gospel-centered, compassionate, and influential voice in your girl's life. I hope to help equip and empower you with resources and practical takeaways, whether you're looking for ways to intentionally connect or to have hard conversations. So don't fret, Mama. Instead, take heart. Okay, we're going to finish talking about what we were talking about with our Gen Zs with faith and the church. And some of the things we were talking about is that Gen Z is the most post-Christian generation ever, and that atheism is on the rise. 37% say that it isn't possible to know for sure God is real. And many teens believe truth is relative and unknowable. So we want to go ahead and dig a little deeper and see what else they think about faith and the church. We are doing this to understand them better so that we know how to pray for our children. We know how to build into relationship with them so that we can have gospel-oriented conversations and so that we know what we're dealing with. So let's get started. Of Gen Zers see people at the church as hypocritical, and one quarter say that the church is not a safe place to express doubts. 17% say church seems too much like an exclusive club. As far as the importance of church, only 20% of Gen Zers who attend church say that it's very important, while 64% say it's not personally relevant. So this tells me that we've got work to do as parents, leaders, and the church. This information that I received and researched is from Barna Group, and you'll be able to get their resource in the show notes. They do a good job of comparing the society at whole with the belief system of Christians. So the question is, where can we start to work towards heart transformation instead of behavior modification in our teen and tween's life? We want them to understand that a relationship with Jesus is personal and that it is between them and God, or them and Jesus, and that he is for them and that he loves them. So we have to start with ourselves. And so I'm just going to list a few things that we can do to help guide them in that direction. Well, the first thing I would have to say is to invest in your relationship. Ephesians 4:6 tells us, "Fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord." So we know, instead of exasperating them, which it does not help the situation at all, we want to try to spend time with them once a week or biweekly. Spend that time connecting with your tween or teen girl and do something that she likes to do. Go for a walk together, a coffee shop, or someplace that she enjoys. Now, I used to take my daughter out for coffee or hot cocoa once a week. We are in the age of the pandemic, so you'd have to go somewhere that has outdoor seating, or you could do a pickup to go and sit in a park and chat. Another thing you can do is have a movie night and let her pick the movie. Or you can sit with her and watch her favorite show. When I took my daughter out for coffee, we would go and spent about an hour. And when she was younger, we would do a girls' Bible study together. And we were able to do this through middle school until about the eighth grade. Then she didn't want to do the Bible study with me. She just wanted to sit with me and talk with me. Well, I honored that. And we would go out once or a week or once every other week and just sit and have, I would have a tea or a coffee and she would have her hot cocoa and until she started drinking coffee. And we would just chat. And that was a way I got to know what was going on in her world. And you will sit through conversations about boy bands, maybe the latest video or one of her favorite TV shows. But you'll also sit through conversations about what's going on with her friendships, any peer pressures that she's feeling, if she's feeling pressured from school, those sorts of things. I also did things like play board or card games. And we're a board game family, so we would play board games at least once a week. And a lot of times we did the kids versus the parents. We thought that would be a good bonding experience for the kids. And it worked. It was good. It bonded them together if they were against us. You might want to play a video game with them, maybe like Mario Kart. And I've even seen parents make TikTok videos with their kids. Now, my kids aren't on TikTok, but at one time, we would have lip sync battles. Needless to say, I never won a lip sync battle, but for them, it was fun. And another thing you can do is just make a video for the family and have someone choreograph the video. And you don't have to share it if you don't want. You just do it on your own. But just find ways to connect with things that she enjoys doing. This is the relationship building part. And this is the part that leads to trust. And that trust will eventually lead to deeper conversations about her world. The second thing we can look at doing is we want to listen and be fully present. Matthew 11:15 tells us, whoever has ears, let them hear. Now we know Jesus is talking about, let them hear him. And we know that is what we want our children to do also. But when we're spending time with our tween or teen, we want to give them the example. We want to be an example for them. So we want to keep distractions to a minimum, which means you want to turn off notifications for a while. Don't check your emails or answer non-urgent or emergency text messages. Listen intently using eye contact and non-verbal gestures that will let them know that you're listening. You want to ask relevant follow-up questions that come from a place of interest instead of judgment. And that's something I had to learn to work on. What sounds like a regular question to us may sound like judgment to them. So I asked my daughter to tell me when she thought I was being judgmental. It taught me to see things through her eyes. And she's in college now, and I'm still working on this. It doesn't mean you can't speak truth of God's word to them. It means that you're just building trust. These ongoing girl dates will allow for truth-speaking conversations. And sometimes it's good to listen without offering commentary or advice. Another thing that I had to learn. Once you establish a trusting relationship, more than likely, they will seek guidance from you. Because my daughter will say, what do you think? And when she says that, I know that's a cue. She wants my input. A third thing that we can do, which is, of course, I would say one of the most important, is to pray. Start by praying for yourself, for praying for a humble heart, and for eyes that will see your girl through God's eyes. And as much as we love our children, he loves them even more. And also I would say, so you pray for yourself, for humility, for the ability to listen without speaking, and for the ability to stand in her shoes. Also, you want to pray for her. There is power in prayer, as we know. And lifting your daughter up to the Lord, interceding for her. is one of the most powerful things you can do. And also pray over her. Allow her to hear you wash God's words over her, cementing who she is in Christ. Did you know to your tween or teen, ending a sentence with a period in the digital communication age is known as a full stop? What's that, you ask? That's a good question. To us, it's grammatically correct to end a sentence with a period. For them, it conveys anger and can make them anxious. So instead, a suggestion is to try using exclamation points, because to them, it's interpreted as excitement. Also, adding emojis to the conversation makes it a little more lighthearted and can convey a more gracious message for them. Well, this has been tough. I know there's a lot to take in, and it's a very different world than what we grew up in. And we know that. And just learning about them, that's the first step. Learning who they are, what their belief systems are. And, you know, this is not everyone's going to feel exactly this way, but this is what's going on in the culture. And so we need to know what's going on in the culture so we will know how to guide and teach our children. As mentioned before, the resources used, they will be in the show notes, are Pew Group Research. They focus more on society as a whole. The Barna Group, which does a great job of comparing the society with a Christian belief system. The Center for Disease Control, Youth Risk Behavior Survey Trends Report, and access.org. That's a ministry that is dedicated to connecting parents, teens, and Jesus in a disconnected world. They have so many helpful guides, videos, etc. Some that you will need to buy and pay for, and some of them are 99 cents sometimes when they're on sale and you can just download them, and some are $1.99 for some of the parental guides that they have. They have a guide to everything. So I would definitely suggest using Access. And if you subscribe to their newsletter, that's a really good one because they talk about timely what's happening right now and how to engage your teen to see where they stand and how they feel about things. That has been a very, very great tool for me to use. Well, it's been good spending time with you today. And I ask you to join us on our next episode when we'll talk about cancel culture and what it is. What does it teach our tweens and teens about mistakes, sin, and redemption? Remember, God is for you and you are not alone. With His Spirit, you are filled with courage and strength of purpose. So don't fret, Mama. Instead, take heart.
Mama Take Heart is a production of Life Audio and the Salem Web Network. If you liked what you just listened to, would you take a second and leave us a rating in your favorite podcast app? It really does help more people like you find our show. This podcast is produced by me, Kelly Givens, and Steven Sanders, with executive oversight by Stephen McGarvey. You can find more podcasts like this over at lifeaudio.com.